Hi, my name is Ellana Kelter. I'm a 2002 graduate of Sauk Prairie High School. I went on to Western Michigan University for a BFA of Music Theater Performance, which I graduated in 2005. And then I followed my way down to Austin, Texas, was there for a while performing, doing some other schooling and training, and then went back up to Columbia College in Chicago for a Master's of Arts Management in 2012. And then I was brought back down to Austin, Texas, where I am happily here now, again, performing and living, loving all of that. There have been many career highlights for me, but I'm going to stick with three. The first would be when we had done a video sketch of a sketch we're doing in the show I was in currently at Esther's Follies. It was about Beto O'Rourke, who was running for Senate, and it became very popular, and unbeknownst to us, and we didn't really know a lot about social media, it became sort of viral. In fact, Senator Ted Cruz at one point tweeted a picture of my face from this video, and the clip made it onto Fox News, national news. They were not in support of our support for Beto O'Rourke, but it was pretty funny to get that kind of viral video attention. It was a really fun piece to do. Another highlight for me was part of the work I do at Esther's Follies was a magician's assistant, or is a magician's assistant. And for one of our shows, we had an audience full of magicians from all around the world. They're a very eclectic, unique group of people. And the magician I work with, Ray Anderson, was being honored with a fellowship award, and this International Magic Magazine had written him up for his beautiful work, including our partnership, where it was quoted, I was one of the top in the world as far as magician assistant. Again, it's a small niche world, but I was very proud of that moment. I worked really hard to be a good magician's assistant. And the third and final one, just to bring in the rest of what I do in my life, would be recently, my current partner, Lon, and I produced a show out in this beautiful state park here where we had, they're called Feast of Fools. I've done them every year for the last 7 years, but I think something about it being outdoors during this time has been stressful for people. It was really magical to have performers and sound bowls and people sharing vulnerably things that they'd like to sort of goals or aspirations they have. And it was a really, really beautiful highlight for me. I'm lucky to have spent a good chunk of my performing life and currently at a theater in Austin, Texas called Esther's Follies. It's the longest running vaudeville show in America. We've actually been around that long. And I've been there, I think, since 2007. There were a couple little breaks. I had some injuries. I took some time to go to grad school. And it has been one of the greatest gifts of my life because we have a small theater that seats about 300, but we sell out most every show. And the ability, the opportunity to do that amount of shows and interact with audiences like that is just, I'm just so grateful for it. The Sauk Prairie Music program completely impacted my life. I think my parents, both being musicians and artists, laid a foundation for that being a part of my life. But once I was able to work with Greg Lorenz, Denny Kahn, and then into the high school programs, it was different than other friends that I've had that have grown up as performers and their foundational, like high school education. We had a great discipline. We had also some great philosophy brought into our experiences. So it was like we were doing the work and technically learning so well the work, but also they brought a lot of the whimsical, seeing the big picture and staying true to yourself, or you know, all of that. So I think the Sauk Prairie music community, I don't know if I would have done this path had I not had a lot of those people and those experiences. Our community is incredibly supportive. I can go back to, first of all, my parents, my mom, who believed, they both believed in me so much and gave me opportunities as even a tiny, tiny little one, you know, yelling out lines and dances. Denny Kahn gave me my first solo in Middle Level Motion. Incredible. Sue and Karen, of course, I can't not talk about them. Voice teachers along the way, We have such a supportive educational system, but mostly I have to go back to my parents, because never once did they say, you know, you should pick something more practical or logical. They always supported me doing this realm and world that you don't always have job security with. They really inspired me and supported me. There were many moments that I felt very downtrodden, or, you know, so much so that I quit and left. Specifically at Esther's, it had to do with the magic and some injuries that I had to that happened. You know, accidents happen. It is a dangerous job because it's so precise for where you're positioned and where you are. And I never would have thought I would do magic in my life. It was a surprise to me, but it was something I ended up being very good at until, you know, something goes wrong. And the magician, I had really good communication, but after a last neck injury, I, you know, had to leave, quit. And I didn't think I'd go back. Honestly, I thought I was too scared and too really down about the whole thing. But I have returned, and it's a slow process. When I was leaving high school, my definition of success would have been on Broadway. That's what I thought my path was, a Broadway musical. And I am so grateful to Jessica Lanius, who I randomly as an 18-year-old, it would have been when I was 21, doing a showcase in New York as you graduate from college for casting agents and casting directors. And I didn't get an agent. I wasn't nearly at the caliber to be on Broadway at that time in my life, but got to meet with Jessica Lanius, and she was like, well, do you want to perform? What do you want? And I was like, I want to perform my whole life. And she reminded me that that can be anywhere, and that can be so many different ways than what I was envisioning it to be. So now my definition of success has to come from doing what you really love and being surrounded by people that you really love. So it's less specific, but much more meaningful. If I could go back to my 18-year-old self, I think I would say, find the you in you. And I know that's hard to do when you're young, but truly I think little hangups I had along my career was when I was trying to be someone else. And it's good to mimic and be inspired by people that you love and try to perform like them, but finding the most qualities that make you you and then playing them up, I think I would have benefited from starting earlier on. I also would say, remember that we are just a blip here. Life moves so quickly that having more fun and not being quite so serious or hard on yourself is really important if you can do that.